Hi, Professor Vern. Should I even ask what this is? A new fuel additive?
Oh, good morning, Administrator. Oh, it's just something I'm brewing. How may I help you today?
Well, Professor Vern, I'm very excited about how we're improving bus travel times using TSP. Can you please help explain it to me?
I'd be glad to explain TSP, but first, it's just about ready. Ah, perfectly brewed tea. Anyway, yes, TSP, that's Transit Signal Priority. As you know, that's the technology that enables our buses to move more efficiently through intersections.
Exactly. In some cases, we've been able to reduce travel times by up to 20% using TSP.
Absolutely. Now, before we discuss TSP, we first need to discuss how traffic signals work. To start with, there are two types of intersections, fixed time and actuated. With fixed time, the lights endlessly display their green, yellow, red lights, regardless of traffic conditions into all lanes of the intersection. Whereas with actuated, which is the more common, by the way, the lights only go green based on knowing if traffic is waiting for the light.
Cool. So that explains why some lights only go green if cars are waiting.
Exactly. Now, a basic intersection has three parts. There's the traffic lights, the signal controller, and vehicle detection. The signal controller is the computerized brains that controls everything. And the vehicle detection, that's circuitry that's buried under the roadway in the approach to the intersection.
Professor Vern, that's so interesting. So how does it all work?
Great question, Administrator. Traffic intersections are programmed with a timing plan. And this is done by a traffic signals engineer, a great career, by the way. Now, what's a timing plan? So a timing plan shows the cycle time for the intersection. Let's assume our intersection has a 120-second cycle. That means if you're watching the light, it will go green every 120 seconds. Now, the cycle is broken into phases, the green, the yellow, and the red. In our intersection, the timing plan shows 70 seconds for the green phase, 10 seconds for the yellow phase, and 40 seconds for the red phase.
That's so cool, Professor Vern. So, how do we add TSP to an intersection?
Ah, I'm getting to that. Next, we have to add the TSP equipment. The TSP equipment includes a TSP radio and a phase selector, which gets added into the signal controller. We also add TSP equipment onto every bus, and that includes a global position system or GPS receiver, a TSP controller, and a TSP radio.
That's a lot of parts, Professor Vern. So how does TSP work?
Great question, Administrator. The intersection uses its TSP radio to broadcast what I call a TSP request. Now, the buses gather their speed, position, and heading from GPS satellite data, and when a bus hears a TSP invitation, it replies back with a TSP request, along with telling the intersection its current position and speed.
So the bus is saying, "Can I please have a green light?"
Not exactly that simple, but close enough. The TSP phase selector receives the TSP request from the bus along with other information and decides whether to grant it signal priority. Now, this is based on certain conditions, such as, would the bus already get a green light?
That's fascinating. So what happens if a bus is granted priority?
You're full of great questions today, Administrator. There are two TSP scenarios that can happen. The first is called green light extension. And in this scenario, the light is green, but our bus is slightly too far away and it's going to miss the light. Well, let's revisit the timing plan for our intersection and recall that our green phase is normally 70 seconds long. In this scenario, the TSP phase selector will extend our green phase by, in this case, 10 seconds. Thus, TSP is holding the light green long enough for our bus to clear the intersection.
Wow, I wish I had a button in my own car for that.
Oh, don't we all, Administrator? Anyway, the other TSP scenario is called shortened red light or red light truncation. And in this scenario, the light is red for the approaching bus. Recall that our red phase is normally 40 seconds. Well, in this scenario, TSP will shorten the red light by, in this case, 10 seconds. Thus, the light comes back to green earlier to allow our bus to clear the intersection.
Wow, that's amazing, Professor Vern. I'd like to see the TSP equipment on the bus.
Absolutely, Administrator. Let's go to a bus division and check it out. Would you care for some tea first?
No thanks, Professor Vern. I prefer a French press over test tubes and beakers.
Ah, yes. Administrator, I've asked our Director of Bus Maintenance, Dave Arner, to give us access to a bus to see the TSP equipment.
That's great. Hi, Dave. How are you today?
Hello, Mr. Quinn. I'm doing great.
Mr. Varner, I can't say how much I appreciate you helping us today. I wanted to show the administrator the TSP equipment on the bus.
Of course, Professor Vern. You know I love working on your special projects. But safety first, I must require the use of fall protection before you go on the bus.
Wow, quite a view from up here.
Absolutely. Administrator, check this out. Inside this device is the TSP radio and the GPS antenna.
Cool, so every bus has these installed?
Absolutely, Administrator. Our entire bus fleet is now TSP equipped. And in fact, we're continuing to outfit more intersections with TSP equipment. You see, by avoiding red light waiting times at multiple intersections, TSP can provide an overall substantial time savings benefit to improve our bus service for the public.
Professor Vern, I can't thank you enough for describing how TSP works and how it improves our bus service.
My pleasure, Administrator.
Well, I've learned so much today. Now, I just have to get off this bus safely.